Hello, welcome to the Pop-Off PC Mag's video game show. I'm Jordan Miner. We talk about big games on the show, but sometimes we talk about things that are more like gaming phenomenons, things that sort of defy genre labels and whatnot. That's why today we're talking about Roblox. And joining us to talk about Roblox is our resident Roblox expert, Mr. Heath Haskins.
Hello.
Heath, thanks for joining us.
Not a problem.
Now, I like to think that I know a lot about video games. I've been doing this for a while, but sometimes it feels like something will just come seemingly out of nowhere, that I'm like, where did this come from? Everyone loves this. I don't even know what it is. So in that spirit, my first question here is, what is Roblox?
Well, Roblox isn't really a game. A lot of people, a lot of kids will say, do you play Roblox? Do you play Roblox? Saying, do you play Roblox is kind of like saying, do you play Java? Whenever you're referring to Minecraft. Minecraft is written in Java. Right. So Roblox is kind of the construct to create Roblox games. So Roblox itself is not a game. It is a platform sandbox, if you will.
Okay. So like on one end, you have Minecraft, which is a game, and this is closer to maybe like the Unreal Engine.
Correct.
Okay. Which is what powers Fortnite and all these other Unreal games. Okay, cool. So if people want to check that out, we do have coverage of different kind of game engines. Okay, so then I guess how did you discover Roblox? How did you come to learn what it is?
Okay, so back in the day, I would say about 2016, my kids, they were young and they were growing up and they were watching people on YouTube. And I kind of got tired of all the cursing and cussing and screaming that was going on inside the YouTube world before the whole adpocalypse came along. And I thought to myself, I could do this. I could create gameplays for my kids that don't have cussing, yelling, stuff like that. So I started doing little stuff like Minecraft gameplays. And they really got into this one YouTuber called Ethan Gamer, a little British kid back in the day. And he played Roblox. He played obbies and he was just like, oh, that's so good. That's so good. And he really started getting into it. So I went to go just look to see what Roblox was. And thought, hey, that's something me and my kids could probably play together and have some fun with. And it just, it snowballed from there. Like, it wasn't just a game. It was a place where you could go and create your own games. And I thought, I'm a developer. I like games. Like, I could probably do this. And that's when I fell down the Roblox rabbit hole so bad. So
cool. So that's a very wholesome story. Definitely need a lot more of that when it comes to making content on the internet. You touched on this, but Roblox, part of the reason, or like probably the driving reason why it's such a huge thing, is that kids are really into it. And just kind of having seen it like firsthand, like what is it about Roblox you think that attracts kids to it so much?
The simplicity. I mean, that's what it comes down to. The basics of being able to have everything at your fingertips to create and imagine. That's what kids do. That's why we play with Legos as kids. That's why we have, this is going to age me, Lincoln Logs, stuff like that. Like, that's what powers Roblox itself. And there's been a lot of controversy about like, oh, child labor and blah, 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 blah. Throw all that right out the window. First off, with Roblox, you don't have to pay for your server uptimes. You don't have to pay for like your development teams to keep the servers up in the background, the DNS records, it's all taken care of for you. So that's one of the great benefits of being able to create games inside Roblox versus like Unity, Unreal Engine. You have to do all the other backend stuff by yourself. So this just, it's a place to go and create and imagine and do.
Yeah, that stuff can get very complicated extremely quickly, especially if you don't know how to code, which is itself like learning a whole other language. Cool. So you said that the simplicity is kind of the key there. So people kind of can dig in and kind of figure out for themselves. But, you know, you having used it for a while and having, you know, you are a Roblox expert, I guess people who want to get in for the first time and start making a game, what are some of your like kind of initial advice and tips for them?
Be prepared. If you just want to build things, you can absolutely go in there and just build models and create things. But if you're going to get into the game making part of it, where you've got rounds, you've got teams, you've got other stuff like that, you're going to have to learn the language, which is Lua scripting. And that's Lua is a huge part of a ton of games. So.
And you think also like having just in the process of learning that you could transition some of those skills into like other, like learning other programming languages or just sort of other programming concepts.
Absolutely. I would actually say Lua is a more lower level language because you have .NET and you have a lot of the higher languages that use APIs that are already built into libraries and DLLs and stuff like that. With Lua, you're taken back to like a very basic version of programming scripting language, and it's hugely powerful. If you can learn Lua, you can go and transition those skills to any other language.
Cool. So again, talk about simplicity, but what's some of the coolest stuff that you've seen people make with Roblox, and in terms of like, what are some like advanced things that people can do that you were like, wow, I didn't even realize that this was even capable of doing something like this?
So I was working with a team of developers and they started getting into the Roblox APIs for HTTP requests and web hooks. So they're actually taking their games and tying them into their Discord servers so they can administer who's playing from inside the Discord server. So like if something happens inside the game on Roblox, they're getting messages about it. And like they've got logs and they've got ban tools and all this other stuff that is integrated across webhooks. And it's just insanely integrated.
Nice. That sounds like a really cool kind of just like community feature. Like we're all sort of in the same ecosystem here. Cool. Mm-hmm. Like any other like just something like really maybe like in terms of like game mechanics or other sort of like really creative things you maybe have seen?
Yeah, VR. Seeing some of the new games that are coming out, Roblox comes with like a very basic interface for like Oculus headsets or Oculus Rift, stuff like that. And just recently within the last couple of months, they started updating how you can create your own VR games inside Roblox. So you can take your headset, throw it on and bam, you're in a Roblox game in VR.
Sweet. That's really cool. And yeah, it's something that to be able to do simply would be great, I guess, to sort mm-hmm. of like for experimentation.
Well, with all the new meta stuff coming out, with all the new virtual right. reality and the price of headsets coming way down. So now it's commercially available.
And then excuse my ignorance. Is it on mobile? Is there a mobile version of it? Or is it just on? Okay. So then, even better because people do things like put your phone in a cardboard and kind of do sort of like kind of bootstrap VR that way. So,
You can play Roblox on PC. You can play it on mobile. You can play it on tablet. You can play it on Xbox, and I'm not sure if PlayStation has got it. But you can also play it from consoles as well. So
very cool. Now you touched on this a little bit, but there is this whole like economic side to Roblox where mm-hmm. people are making money and then selling and whatnot. I guess, again, 101, like, what is that? And how does that all work?
So there's a program called DevX. And where you are a developer and you start creating a game and people are purchasing your in-game items or access to your game, whatever means you have to getting the currency, which is Robux, once you get to, I think it's 100,000 Robux, you can cash that out. You can go to Roblox's website and say, hey, I've got this amount of Robux and I want to transfer it. And for, I think it's 100,000 Robux, you can get like $350. So it's not a one-to-one ratio and it kind of fluctuates every once in a while, but you can make a living by creating Roblox games. That's not to get everybody's hopes up because not everybody's going to jump in there and make one game and bam, you're a millionaire. It doesn't happen. But for the ones that are doing it right now, I've got a couple of friends who they were in high school and their game took off and one of them bought a Tesla because he made enough money from from Robux.
It's a very it's a very like 2022 kind of story.
Mm-hmm. It's happening more and more often too.
Cool. But again, as with anything involving real money and games and kind of these online interactions, I think parents especially would be kind of wary about like, what is my kid getting into here? So I guess like, what should they know in regards to the money stuff to kind of, what should they do to kind of stay cautious or kind of stay safe involving that stuff? Avoid scams too.
First off, with parents, all right, you're letting your child onto the internet. So I want to make it sure that everybody knows Roblox, like any other platform, is the internet. I mean, it could be safe or it could not be. There's a lot of stuff that happens on the internet, and Roblox is no exception to it. So when it comes to monitoring your children, go and create accounts and jump in with them. Go play alongside, see what's happening. That's my best advice. If they are telling you, hey, I could make some money at this, go and look at it. There's tax forms that you can fill out, and you can sign up as their parental guardian to grant permission. They have it all lined out and ready for you. You just have to read it. And a lot of parents nowadays, they'll just take their phone, log it in, and then hand it to the child. Like, you got to go and monitor what your children are doing. Then that's 100%. I believe in that. So
you're saying that parents should be involved in their children's lives?
Absolutely.
Wow. What a revolutionary thought.
Every second of the day, you should be a helicopter mom or a tiger mom. Yeah. Do the tiger mom thing.
Cool. Okay. So like I said, from the jump, I really don't know a whole lot about it. I kind of asked these sort of basic questions, but I guess is there other things that you think that people should know about it, or there are cool things that you would like to tell people about? Like, you know, this is, you know, what you're the expert. So.
I love how you keep telling me that I'm the expert. I'm like this underlying person that has a lot of different connections to the huge Roblox YouTuber stars and all the different developers. And it's weird because you have these two different entities. Like, you have the Roblox YouTubers, and then you have the developer or the Roblox developers. And it's always been this weird, like, competition in between each other. Because like Roblox has the Roblox Star program for the Roblox YouTubers. And then they also have this this Roblox DevCon, which all the developers get. And it's weird because I'm kind of sitting on both sides. I make videos, but I don't want to be like the big star. I know how to develop the games, but I don't want to be the next big jailbreak, which is like one of the top games. So I kind of sit in the middle and just see all the different sides. And that's what my expertise is. I know what Roblox is, and that's what I want to do. I want to spread the knowledge of Roblox to parents and just get parents to understand what your kids are getting into. And you should be aware of it with any online game.
So you are sharing that knowledge on PC Mag, which obviously people should read if they're watching this PC Mag video.
Absolutely.
But also you're sharing it in an upcoming book. So if you know, we'll plug that or talk about that, now is the time to do that. That's why you're the expert. It's in print.
Yes. And it's kind of funny because David was the first one to write the first book of the Roblox Ultimate Guide series. And Rebecca was my publisher, and she came to me in, I think it was an email or it was a Facebook Messenger post. And at first I thought it was a scam. So I'm like, oh yeah, right. Yep, you're whoever. And then I started getting into it and looking deeper, and I'm like, oh, she really does work for like Simon and Schuster. She's part of Adams Media. Okay. So let's talk. What's going on? And when I found out that they needed somebody for the development side of the book, like the programming side of the book, I'm like, okay, let's go be an author. So
sweet. It's a cool feeling, isn't it?
Yeah. Like this kid out of high school who had ADHD and was told by the counselor, you can't play video games for a living. Okay.
We're both just showing them. We're showing them. Yeah.
That's cool. That's where it came from.
So the book it's the new edition of the Ultimate Roblox book.
Yep, the Ultimate Roblox Guide by Adams Media, subsidiary of Simon & Schuster.
Sweet. So look out for that. Again, keep reading Heath's coverage of Roblox on PC Mag. Heath Haskins, thanks so much for joining us.
Not a problem. I do have another plug if you
want. Oh, go for it. Yes, go for it.
There's also going to be an updated version of the Advanced Roblox Coding Book, which is coming out in January, February, March, April, May 1st of this year. So that's that's going to be the fourth book in the series, third book that I've written. So
cool. Oh, and also, I mean, so what's your YouTube channel also?
Oh, YouTube, youtube.com/code_prime8, or just Google Heath Haskins. I'll be on there somewhere.
Cool. So yeah, when you're not playing Roblox, check out all that out, all this other supplemental Roblox material. There's plenty of it. So yeah, Heath Haskins, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And we'll talk to you next time.